Happy birthday. Can we say that?
Absolutely. Very happy birthday. It feels feels one of the longest years in my life, and it's also gone incredibly quickly.
So, very difficult year for all our gallery and museums and all the cultural events, but somehow this one looks amazing and ready to for a new life and start.
Absolutely. I mean, as you've said, it's not just us, everyone, you know, who welcomes people in Brighton. The whole tourist cultural sector has had an incredibly difficult year, and indeed it hasn't ended. You know, we're still a lot of unpredictability, how quickly visitors will come back, how quickly the economy will rebuild. But right now, as we finish the first year, all of our museums open, we're welcoming visitors back, the visitors are coming back, it's lovely to see them. It's also nice that school parties are coming back. We were particularly worried about, again, it's all about confidence, how confident people feel to come back and be in spaces. And generally speaking, I think what we're seeing is a huge appetite that people really missed coming to museums. They missed the sort of social interaction, social learning. Again, it's a downside of the last year, that last November, just when, you know, we were incredibly pleased that we won the Society of Museum Archaeologists Award for best new archaeology gallery, our Elaine Evans gallery downstairs that had opened before before the pandemic. It's now open again, and we can now share that award with people. And it's great news. Archaeology has traditionally always been a very important part of museums. But galleries tend to get old, and the approach quite old-fashioned, and the fact we could offer a new look at archaeology, new look at the past. It's such an important long period of our country's past that often isn't given a lot of emphasis in museums. When people think of Brighton, they don't think of archaeology and prehistory. But this is a really important area, and we've got really important objects in there and really important stories to tell about early farmers, early hunter-gatherers in this area.
So now it's a trust. What was the difference between last year and this year?
So most importantly, although Brighton and Hove City Council are still very supporting to us, we're on our own. We're looking after ourselves, which means that it puts more pressure on us, but it also gives us greater freedoms to try new things, you know, and we're currently thinking about how can we maximise our assets here, how can we raise more money, how can we do more fundraising, how also can we respond more quickly to what's going on. So we recognise right now we need to think, how can we think about bringing visitors back more quickly with exhibitions. So it gives us far greater freedoms to try and be as effective as possible as a museum. I think, you know, most people in the council will say any council, local authorities and councils have got really important things to do to look after. Culture and museums probably is not going to be a top priority, so giving it to an independent trust to worry about allows them to concentrate on other things. But I would always say Brighton and Hove City Council have been incredibly supportive to us, and absolutely recognise the value of museums and culture and arts to Brighton, and indeed I think that's one of the reasons they did create an independent trust.
Of course, tourists that come to Brighton, it's one of the first things they want to see, to know about the history of Brighton. It's the Brighton Museum, of course, and the Pavilion. But I notice now that there are two different tickets. There used to be like one ticket for all.
We're looking at different tickets. Different. You can still buy a single ticket and do everything. But we recognise that some people will want to do different things. And I think that's the way it's going, isn't it? To try and offer as much flexibility as possible. The ticket. If people buy the bigger ticket, it's there for a year. And what, of course, we'd really like to see is as many people as possible becoming members so they can come back again and again and get all the benefits. But what we do want to do is offer everyone the options and choices to do as many things as possible. And of course, we have got other museums. We've got the Booth and Hove Museum and Preston Manor. A couple of them are free, open at different times. We're about to redesign our website. We'll look at pricing again. These are the very things we can do as a trust to try and make sure as many people as possible know about everything it is we have to offer. as you say, the Royal Pavilion is the thing that most people will know about, most people are drawn to. We've got the garden around the pavilion, we've got Brighton Museum. We'd love people to come to both, and we'd love people who are staying a bit longer to also think about visiting our other museums as well.
Brilliant. So a visitor comes to the Brighton Museum today, this week, this month. What can they enjoy?
So we've still got fabulous David Bowie photographic exhibition. It's with us until Christmas. Unique, no photos nobody's seen before by David's close friend, Jeff McCormack. That's here. The gallery we're in now, as you see, great collection of paintings inspired by a Spencer Gore painting we acquired of the West Pier, and it gave us an excuse to bring out this great group of paintings from Gore and his contemporaries from the so-called Camden Town Group. A lot of them are of Sussex, so you've got a great art gallery. Further down, we've got an exhibition on some of the designs for the Royal Pavilion. And then there are all the standard galleries. We've talked about the archaeology gallery. There's an Egyptology gallery, decorative arts. This is a great museum. You know, I mean, even if the pavilion wasn't here, our collections here in this museum would comfortably go to most places in the world, and people would say, "Oh, that's a great museum." Brighton people are very lucky. Up at Booth, you know, incredible natural history museum. Hove, we've got a really nice contemporary ceramics exhibition. And Preston Manor, as ever, you know, a beautiful time capsule of Edwardian life. And that's without, as you said, going back to Royal Pavilion, a completely unique, amazing royal palace owned by a local authority in a seaside town.